Good morning, student. Today we are going to start the new example of polynomial. In the last lecture, we have studied the definition of the polynomial and we have studied the types of the polynomial. Now, in this lecture, we'll discuss about the coefficient of the polynomial of variable and we will see the degree of the polynomial. So, first of all, we need to understand what is in my coefficient. Coefficient is nothing but the multiple of the number. Okay? If I write, suppose you can see here. Suppose I am writing one of the polynomial, that is 3x square plus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. Suppose this is the polynomial. So in this polynomial, this is the algebraic expression of degree 2. Okay? So degree is nothing but the highest power of that equation. In this equation, what is the highest power? You can see 2. 2 is the highest power. So degree of this equation will be 2. Degree of this equation will be 2. Now we have to see what are the coefficients. So coefficients are nothing but the multiple of the number. So here you can see the multiple. X square multiple is, the multiple of x square is 3. So 3 is the coefficient, here 2 is the coefficient, and here 1 is the coefficient. These 3 numbers are the coefficient of that polynomial. But in that coefficient, there are different coefficients are there. If they are, find the coefficient of x square only. So you have to see the multiple number of x square. If they ask, find the coefficient of x only. So you have to write 2. If they ask, find the coefficient of constant, that is 1. This is the constant number. So this is the polynomial, okay? And degree is nothing but the highest power of that equation. And the coefficient is nothing but, this is the coefficient. And coefficient is nothing but the multiple of the variable, okay? Multiple of the variable. So this two types of example we have to study in this lecture. Okay? So this is the second example, question number 2, and this is the third question. In the question number 2, you can see here, we have to write the coefficient of m cubed. Here m is the variable in each of the given polynomials. Okay? So we have to find the coefficient of m cubed. M is the variable here. And we have to calculate the coefficient of n cube. So in the first example, now here, you can see it is written n cube only. So instead in the n cube, you are not getting any multiple of number. Here you cannot see any number. Is there any number in this multiple? No. So what should we have to write? So if there is no number of multiple in the variable, so we have to write 1. Okay? So the coefficient of n cube here, 1. Now in this question number 2. Okay? We have to find the coefficient of n cube only. Okay? So here it is the polynomial minus 3 upon 2 plus m minus root 3 n cube. So you can see the coefficient of n cube is root 3. But the sign of root 3 is minus here. So the coefficient of n cube will be minus root 3. So minus root 3 is the coefficient of this polynomial. Now next example, minus 2 upon 3 n cube minus 5 m square plus 7 m minus 1. So this is a polynomial. So in this polynomial we have to see where is m cube. So m cube is here and we have to find the coefficient of m cube. The coefficient of m cube is minus 2 upon 3. Okay? So this is the coefficient. So we will write the solution like this. I am writing the solution here for question number 2. Okay? For first, what is the question? M cube. So we have to write coefficient of m cube is 1. Okay? Second, what is the second question? Minus 3 upon 2 plus m minus root 3 m cube. So we have to write coefficient of m cube is equal to, so here it is m cube. What is the multiple of m cube is root 3. But we have to write with sign only. Okay, what is the sign? Negative sign. So we have to write minus root 3. Okay, or third example, that is minus 2 upon 3 n cube minus 5 n square plus 7 m minus 1. So we write here coefficient of m cube is equal to, so what is the multiple of here? You can see minus 2 upon 3. Okay, so coefficient of m cube is minus 2 upon 3. So this complete the question number 2. This complete this example. So have you understood this okay, coefficient is nothing but the multiple of that variable. If they ask, find the coefficient of m only, so you have to see the coefficient of m only, okay. But in this question, they have asked coefficient of m cube. So this complete the example. Now we'll proceed ahead. That is question number 3. Write the degree of the given polynomial. To understand the degree, first we need to understand the power. Okay? So here you can see. If I am taking only number 5. So what is the degree of this number? Okay? There is no variable here. There is no any variable. Only number is there. So if the number is there, the degree of that number will be 0. Degree will be 0. Degree kitna hoga? 0. Degree will be 0. If I am taking 5x, for example. If I am taking 5x. But here you can see 5 is a number, x is a variable. But in the x variable, you cannot see any power here. Okay? So if there is no power on x, that means there is a 1 power. So degree will be 1. Okay, if only variable is there, okay, without any power, then the degree will be 1. If no variable is given, only number is given, then the degree will be 0. These two important points you have to understand. Okay, these two important points you have to understand. All remaining examples will be easy. Okay, so here the questions are given. You can see, write the degree of the given polynomial. Here it is root 5 only, no variable. If there is no variable, what will be the degree of this question? 0. What is the degree of that question? 0. Here only variable is written, no power is written, that means degree will be 1. Here x raised to 2, degree is already there, power is 2, that means degree will be 2. Here root 2 m raised to 10 minus n, and here two numbers are given, two terms are given. So which term we have to consider? We have to consider those terms which have highest order. Which term have highest order? Root 2 m raised to 10. Out of these two terms, m raised to 10 is the highest power. It has a 10 power. So degree will be 10. Okay. If you have given more than two terms, okay, so you have to see which power is more. Okay. So that power you have to consider as a degree. So here 2p minus 5. So degree of 5 will be 0 and 2p. Degree of 2p is 1. So what is the highest degree here? 1. The answer will be 1. Degree of this equation is 1. Here 7y minus y cube plus y raised to 5. So out of this polynomial, 7y is the one term, the degree will be 1. Y cube, the degree is 3. Y raised to 5, the degree is 5. So out of this 3 term, which degree is most highest? 3, 5. So what the degree of whole polynomial will be? 5. Here same, m cube plus 3m square plus 2. Out of this 3 term, which power is highest? The 3 is the highest, then the degree of this polynomial is 3. Understood? So I am writing the solution of this question here. Okay? You have to just understand, if there is no variable, only number is given, the degree will be 0. If there is a variable without any degree, then the degree will be 1. Okay? So I am writing the first example here. Question number 3. First is root 5. Degree is 0. Second, x. Degree is 1. There is no power. Third, x square. Degree is 2. Okay. Fourth, root 2 m raised to 10 minus 7. Now here, these are single term. Here, this is important. Two terms are there. We have to consider those terms which have highest power. So out of these two terms, which terms has highest power? This. So degree, what is the power of this term? 10. So degree will be 10. And fifth, that is 2p minus 5. Here only two, here same two terms are given. So degree of 5 is 0 and degree of 2p is 1. So what is the highest degree out of this? 2p. So degree is 1. Sixth, that is 7y minus 5 cube plus y raised to 5. Three terms are given. Okay. First term has 1 degree. Second term has 3 degree. Third term has 5 degree. So
So out of this three term, which is the highest? 5. So degree will be 5. So this completes this example. This last example you will try with your own. Okay? So we have completed the two examples, question number 2 and question number 3. So I hope you understood this example. Okay? In this lecture we have studied the what are the coefficients and what are the degrees. So I hope you understood. If you have any problem with this lecture, so you can ask me on group. Okay? So I will send you the notes and assignments. Okay? Thank you so much.